Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be recreating an isometric camera in Sketchup. Okay, so when I first started learning how to 3D model and even to draft, the way that I learned in the class that I was in is that we would recreate drawings that had dimensions on them, and then once we had that sort of figured out, we would recreate isometric drawings. So, and that was back in the day when I was learning AutoCAD. So we're gonna be doing the same thing in SketchUp because I think that that was a fun and helpful way to learn when I was first starting. So the first thing you can notice is that these are all in centimeters, I believe. I'm currently in imperial units. So we need to change that. So to do that, you go to Window and then come down to Model Info. And then there is a bar here called Units. Currently I'm in Architectural, but if we change this to either Decimal or Engineering, we can get inches here. I don't see any decimals, so I'm just gonna change this to zero. And I don't want inches, I want centimeters. And this actually might be in millimeters. I'm not familiar with it enough to know, but we're just gonna start with that. So we're gonna start with this shape here as well. So it looks like it's 100 by, we have 15 plus 15, which is 30. So 100 by 30, so we're just gonna put this in. And in the bottom right, you can see it says dimensions, and it's asking me for that. So if you type in 100 and then comma, whoops, I think I hit the wrong button there. 100, comma, 30. We get this guy. Now, obviously, it's much smaller, so I'm just gonna take this and scale it down. Okay. So now we just have that as a reference, and then I'm just gonna rotate this really quick so it's a similar orientation. Obviously, not the same orientation. Okay. So now we have this. So we have the basic shape here. Now we want to take it up 50, and then there's another 10 that it's going up. So a really cool tip here is hit P for the push-pull tool. We're going to go up, type in 50, and then use this again, but instead this time, because we want to go up 10 and make essentially another line, we're going to hit Control here, and that's going to make another face so we get that line, and I don't have to essentially redo everything that I just did. Really quickly we're able to get that. Now to draw this circle, it looks like we need to get the center point first, so it looks like 15 and 15 from here. So what I'm going to do is you could use the guides here. I for some reason I just like really never use the guides. If you wanted to, you just type 15 here and it makes a little tick here. Same thing here. It's actually the center point. So we have like a guide here. If I want to do I'm not sure how this works exactly because I don't really use it that often. There we go. Right, and then just check it, because I don't know what I'm doing with that tool. So we have a little circle here. Hit C for the circle tool. Now this little symbol here means it's the diameter. A lot of times, at least from what I found, is that diameter is used for full circles. Radiuses are used for partial circles, just as a little tip there. So you can see down here it says radius, so we need to half this if that's what we want to do. Or I think, we type D, 20. No. So we'll just half it. I think there is a way to change it. So we're going to delete this, and I'm going to get rid of these guidelines just because it's just driving me crazy a little bit. So you can just select them and delete them. Get rid of that little tick mark, and then it goes up. I think 5. So select that little face there. Hit P for push pull. And then we're gonna go up 5. Now, one thing that I did here is that I didn't make this a group, so everything is gonna be stuck together. We're gonna just make everything stuck together in this particular model because it doesn't matter. all that much if everything is stuck together, because it's a fairly small object. The next thing we're going to do is we want to make this little, well, how about we start with this? So 15:15, again, that if you want to do this a different way, just selecting this line here, hitting M for move, and then you can see it sort of like shapes that a little bit, but if you hit control, it'll make a copy. So I hit 15 there. Same thing here, 15. Makes a little point there. And now this is a, how big is this? I don't think they say. They don't say. So we're just gonna guess. Let's say it's a square, right? This square looks like it might be the same as this. So we'll say 10 by 10 by 5. So we're gonna hit R. Now you can see in the bottom left here, it says select first corner, or you can select start center. So if I hit control, it then goes to the center, and I can type 10 by 10, and it gives me that little shape. Now I'm going to delete the extra stuff. I'm selecting and hitting delete, but if you hit E, you'll get the eraser tool, and you can just really quickly go around. Whoops. Go around. You've got to make sure you don't cut that corner. And then come up 5 because our little button is up 5. So this drawing isn't 100% perfect, and you'll actually probably find that most of the time, is that like one dimension or something is missing. So you have that, and then this is going to come over 35 and then up 10 and then over 30 again. So select this line. We're going to go over 35. Then take this again, 30. Push-pull this up. It's up 10. So I hit P there, up 10. Now this is at a 45 degree angle. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select this line, hit Q. Now you can see this goes crazy a lot, the rotate tool. It can be like, it can drive you absolutely insane. If you use the arrow keys, it'll lock to a specific axes, any of the global axes. So what I can do here is select that and then hit control so it doesn't pull all of this stuff. And then what I'm going to type is 45. So I get that little shape. And then I can just take this, hit P to push pull, go all the way across, and we have our little, I don't know what that thing is, but we have it. Now the last thing that we need to do is put this circle in. It doesn't say that the where the center is, it just shows us the width of this. So we're going to assume that this circle is in the middle. So what I'm going to do is take this line and bring it all the way down. Now, one thing to notice here, because you can make this mistake, is that what I have here is two separate lines. So my tendency at first would be, oh yeah, this midpoint is the center, but it's not. That's the center of this line. We want the center of both of these lines. So if you want to do that, what I would recommend is we're going to delete this. How do we want to go about this? We're just going to draw a little circle off to the side here. I'm going to make it a group, okay? Then go into that group and edit it. And now when I select this group, that's a solid line because it's not intersecting with this other line. Choose the midpoint. Diameter is going to be 25 because our radius is going to be 25 because our diameter is 50. Then we're just going to extrude this out. We can get rid of our lines first so we don't have a half shape. Extrude this out, 20, okay? And there we go. We have our little camera. Obviously, there's more that you could do here to make a more convincing camera, but we've done the task at hand. We've made our isometric drawing. So hopefully this video helped. If you liked it, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.